My bank wanted to charge me $17.63 for 6 years worth of credit card transactions. So instead, I wanted to prove a point and decided to use Python to get them all myself. Now, let me explain the issue here. I closed a credit card account last year, but for this year's taxes, I needed the credit card statements for accounting reasons, I guess. So if I go on my desktop client, my bank doesn't show my credit card to get statements. And so I try going on my mobile app, and surprisingly enough, it's there with all 3 or 4 years of statements, but listed one at a time. So if I did all of them, it would take me like 17 whole minutes just to do that. Worst of all, I had to set up an appointment with my bank to see if they could do an export for me. They said they can only print it, but it would cost $17.63 to print out all of the pages. But like, I'm a programmer. How can I take this 17 minutes and stretch it out over hours? First, I had to figure out how to read the web request that my phone was making, similar to how you can do it on the Chrome DevTools. I found this software called Charles, and it just acts as a proxy for your smartphone. You set it up on your Mac and have your phone run its Wi-Fi request through it. This gives you a detailed log of all the requests being made, and then you can see it kind of like you would on a Chrome DevTools. So I did that setup and started to use my phone as if I was grabbing the credit card transactions off my phone. And when I got the request back, I was so annoyed. When I look at the network request that comes back when you open the credit card statements page, you get every single credit card statement that exists.
Oh, hell no, man. What the fuck, man?
Yeah, really, all 4 years of it. I found that this was an obvious dark pattern to keep you from easily accessing these PDF files that you just obviously want in one go. Most of the time, the data you see on screen in like a table or whatever, it's usually everything that's called from the database, but paginated by that number. So if the first page has 20 results, you're only limiting it to 20 results. In a database, it's faster to get 20 than it is to get 1,000 rows, like obvious. This is why user interfaces with these date-based filters exist. But the annoying thing is that my bank is not doing any limits. It's just grabbing everything, but it's hidden behind a UI, so you have to do that annoying 21 seconds every single time. Why didn't my bank just introduce some multiple download button? I mean, it's clearly done so that you can go into the branch and either pay a fee or maybe accept a home equity line of credit at our newest discounted rate. Let's channel my inner hyperplexed. Now, the way the UI works here is that you can go into one PDF file at a time and filter it by year. So when I open up the year 2022, you can see I get 12 PDFs. But I don't want to press every single PDF document to get them all though. So I'm going to create a button at the very top saying download all statements that's 20 pixels high and 200 pixels wide. I mean, that's a video I wish he made. And this is when I just had to get my Python out. So I grabbed the response from Charles and saved it as a .json file. I then used the request library, like obviously that's just what you do with Python. I looped through each key that specified a URL as well as the cookie headers that already authenticates me and just ran it. And I made sure to add a little timer in between to not look like a complete sketch bag. And just like that, I have every PDF that I needed. Saved so much money. Even cooler is that there's an open source project here that converts the RBC statements to a CSV file, which at the time of this video, my bank also hasn't fixed. Hot take here, but GitHub repositories with barely any stars, maintainers, anything are the absolute goats. They're the hidden gems of GitHub repositories. There's one issue and someone's like, can the code be modified for a checking account? And the guy is like, yeah, I mean, I tried and it didn't really work. You can try though. Like, I mean, that's a baller move. I mean, like, you can try it. I got kids, I got things I gotta do, but yeah, go ahead. It's open source. The banks are smart because they set the price of something like this right at the line where you're like, I don't wanna have to pay for this, but at the same time, it's not too much money, so I'll just spend the money and get it over with. It's annoying. On my channel, I build $10,000 trading bots, AI meme generators, like all these kind of cool stuff, but it's projects like this that make me think, you know what, like I love programming. I love being able to automate stuff. And even though I'm not changing the world with it, it's still pretty interesting to do. Let me know if you want to see more videos like this. Peace out, coders. Yeah, don't stop.